weather.
And a good morning to you. Welcome back to First Edition. Yesterday, we did pretty well. We had just a little bit of rainfall, nothing like we were anticipating. That's good news outside right now. We've got clear to partly cloudy skies. Actually, we're mostly cloudy. Let me show you the radar, because while we had a little bit of shower activity yesterday, we're expecting a little more today. Reason being is the system that moved through here is still just off toward the east. Problem is we got this wraparound moisture. So you see what's happening between Alexandria and Baton Rouge. We are seeing a few more showers going to move through. Also, right around near Morgan City, we're starting to see some more of this shower activity. Again, this little line is going to slide toward the east, southeast. As it does, I think it's going to lose most of its punch. You're seeing we are getting a few thunderstorms embedded in that line. As it passes over us, we'll get a few showers. I think we'll start getting some clearing later on this afternoon. Temperatures, let's take a look. 53 right now in Slidell, 52 in Hammond. Along the Mississippi Gulf Coast, 58 in Gulfport, 55 in Galliano. So all the Catholics watching, if you're going to head out to service and get your ashes, you might need just a light jacket as you head to church. Now, wind speeds, it's going to be a little breezy. Not so much on the North Shore, 5 to 10 miles per hour. Notice around Lake Pontchartrain, 12 and 23 miles per hour. And we get up to 15 miles per hour in Grand Isle. Winds will be ramping up as the rest of this rain finally kicks on out of here. But you know what? With the wind, we've got good visibility. Rainfall totals, not too impressive. Most of the rainfall was focused on the North Shore, over an inch in Hammond, 16/100 in Slidell, 18/100 in Gulfport, and just under a tenth of an inch at Audubon Park. So satellite imagery and the radar imagery. Here's our system right here, the area of low pressure that moved through. You see it's still rather close, so wrapping around this area of low pressure and in the upper levels, we're still dealing with the southwesterly flow. The combination of those two features are going to keep just a few scattered showers in the forecast. Take a look at the forecast model. So here's our line. This is 8 o'clock this morning. And basically, we're just getting the dark greens indicating probably some light shower activity, maybe some light to moderate rainfall. By 2 o'clock this afternoon, that line is basically along the coast. We'll start working in a little bit of clearing. High pressure will start moving in place, and we'll start working in an offshore flow. That's a cool, dry direction. Overnight tonight at midnight, we'll go clear to partly cloudy. And as we get to tomorrow morning, we'll have high pressure in place and clear skies. But notice what's happening back toward the northwest. This is 6 o'clock tomorrow evening. That's another cold front. I don't think it's going to bring us any rain, but it is going to give us another significantly cooler punch of some cold air. It's on your 7-day. I'll show you that in one moment. So upper 50s, lower 60s for today. Temperatures aren't going to be moving a whole lot. A few passing showers, we'll call it. Afternoon clearing, cool and windy. Wind speeds anywhere from 10 to 20 miles per hour. Then temperatures drop off on the North Shore, mid-30s to near 40. And then south, North Shore, that is. And on the South Shore, somewhere in the 40s, clear to partly cloudy with a South Shore breeze. I think winds will relax on the North Shore in the overnight hours. So we'll get the rain out of here. Going to keep it at about 30%. And then we'll be clear and cool tomorrow. A little bit of cloud cover on Friday as that front passes by Saturday. Upper 50s for highs. Check out your morning lows on Saturday. Everyone will be stuck in the 30s. And then as we hit the latter part of the weekend, we'll dip into the lower 60s. And then another rain chance next Tuesday with your highs then back up into the lower 70s. All right, there is your First Edition look at weather. Randy, back to you.